Turkish espresso, Mrs. Cates.
Well, thank you, but I don't think I need another sleepless night. You didn't get any sleep last night? No. I just laid there and thought about Stone, you know? And then I realized Jagger was doing the same thing, so I just gave up sleep entirely and just tried to make sense of all this. But sun came up this morning and we're still just as devastated as we were when we went to bed.
So let's take in a lot of what?
Yeah. How do you accept this?
You don't. I'm just relieved that you know. I mean, he's been so worried about telling you, it started to get to me too, you know?
And how about you?
Well, some days are tougher than others. But mostly Stone and I keep each other steady.
I mean your health. You were exposed, Robin.
I already told you, I tested negative twice.
Just please, please promise me you're gonna be super careful, okay?
Of course I will. First of all, the way Stone's been feeling, he's not really thinking about sex that much anyway. And when he is, I mean, when we are, there are safer ways to love each other. We're very aware, okay?
Okay. Just please stay that way. Brenda, hi.
Hi. It's good to see you. You look great.
Thanks, so do you.
Thanks. Wow. How are you?
I'm really sad, actually.
Oh, Stone told you.
Yeah, right after we got here. We're just both in shock. Yeah.
I know.
But Stone said that you and Sonny have been really good friends to him.
Yeah, Sonny loves him a lot. I mean, he's come through for him in every conceivable way.
And what about you?
You know what? I think I'm gonna get out of here, because I really don't feel like being reminded about how I messed everything up.
No, Brenda, wait a minute. I don't understand. What did I say?
I'm so wiped. I don't think I slept more than an hour last night.
Sometimes I wake up and my sheets are soaked down to the mattress. I don't even bother going back to bed anymore.
You know, when I was laying there, I was thinking about when I was 12 and you were 8 and Gina would have been, what, 6? Before Mom left and everything fell apart. You ever think about those days?
Sometimes. And it's kind of hazy in my mind. I'm not sure which memories are accurate and which parts I'm trying to reinvent to get rid of the parts that I'm trying to forget.
Not me. I remember everything like it was yesterday.
You are so full of it. Oh, right. Okay. Give me an example.
Okay. Remember the time you opened a pack of baseball cards and stuffed a whole piece of gum in your mouth right in front of me? Even though you knew I wanted half.
You're delusional. I never did that.
You did. You're just too guilty to admit it.
Oh, yeah? Well, what was the top card?
Willie Randolph, second base, Yankees, 1986.
Oh, right. Yeah. Well, now I know you're lying because I never had that card.
I stole it because I was too mad about the gum.
You did?
Why did you just wait this long to tell me? How often do we speak? Once a month? You never mention a word.
Damn it! You know, I knew you'd be angry.
I'm not angry at you. I'm just angry that it happened.
You know, anger's a waste of time. That's what this friend of mine with AIDS told me.
So much for my plans.
plans.
I haven't told anybody. Not even Karen. But as soon as I made detective, I was gonna try to come back here and try to nail a job to PCPD. See, I had this fantasy that we'd reconnect with Gina.
So we could what, man? Make up for lost years? Jagger, even if I wasn't sick, that would never happen. We're all adults now. We gotta start our own families.
Maybe that's why I never told her. She'd probably say the same thing. And I know this isn't about me and my plans. But where does this leave us now?
Have to find a plan B in a hurry. Don't ask me what it is, because I don't have a clue.
Well, don't look at me. I was a fool who thought we had everything in front of us to get things together. There I was, taking my sweet time trying to figure it all out.
Well, AIDS has a tendency to mess with the best laid plans.
It's hard. It's hard to accept. I can't yet.
It's not like I'm taking this lying down. I'm putting up a fight. I'm just realistic about who's gonna win.
I don't like being told there's not much time left to make it up to me.
Whoa, make what up to me?
Everything I've done wrong. I was the oldest. It was my job to keep the three of us in one piece. And if I'd done my job right, this wouldn't be happening. And you wouldn't be sick. And you certainly wouldn't be needing Sonny to get you through it.
Sonny's been great. He's been righteous since day one.
I know I should be grateful to him, too. But there's too much I can't forgive him for.
Look, I know you're not going to want to hear this, but Sonny is like family to me. Come on, Jagger. That doesn't mean that I love him more than you, because I don't. I have one brother in this world, and that's you. No one can take the place of that. So as my brother, I need you to stop blaming yourself. I had every chance in the world and I blew it. I mean, you're just a little kid yourself. How are you supposed to stop me when I was on the streets from destroying myself?
I don't know. Something.
This is my life. Let me take the blame for it. Do we see things differently or what?
We always have. I guess some things never change.
No. There's some twisted comfort to that, huh?
Yep. I know you told me not to, but part of me still wants to chuck everything in Chicago and move back here with you.
Forget it. You'd be missing out in Chicago and I'd feel like I took it away from you.
You could move in with us. We have plenty of room. Northwestern has got one of the best medical schools in the country. Karen could set you up with a great doctor there. You should be with your family.
I have family here too.
Robin and Sonny.
And Dr. Quartermain. He's been a major player in all this.
You're lucky. You have a lot of people pulling for you. I just wish we could take care of some stuff that can be dealt with in one day. Or even a year.
What if? What if we pretended like we worked everything out? And we just started right now accepting each other and loving each other right now.
You mean you skip the hard part and fast forward to the payoff?
Yeah, exactly.
You know, That's always been your problem. You have a lousy work ethic.
Well, I'm not about to start changing it now. So what do you say?
Sounds like a plan.
See that? We came up with a plan B all by ourselves. That's what brothers do when they understand each other.
Get over here, bro.
Okay, could someone please tell me what's going on? Because I obviously said something wrong here.
Didn't Stone tell you Sunny and Brenda broke up?
No, I had no idea. I mean, I don't think that Stone really wanted to say much about Sunny in front of me, and I thought I wouldn't ask too many questions. Why? What happened?
I'd really rather not drag you through it if it's okay.
Absolutely. Much better that way.
Look, I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to overreact. I'm a little raw on the subject.
It's okay. Another word said. Okay?
This is closer to old times than I think we wanted to get.
No, you know, Ruby, everything's just fine out here. I think that there are enough real problems going on to waste time and energy on stupid arguments.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. Sorry. Yes. Sorry.
Well, my one indulgence, though, is houseplants. I love them. I have them in every room, and I do everything short of telling them bedtime stories. Jagger laughs at me. He says they're my substitute kids for right now.
Welcome back.
Thank you. How you been, Brenda?
Oh, God, where do I begin?
Would you guys come upstairs and help me bring the luggage down?
You bet.
So subtle, Karen.
Well, we just have so little time here, and everybody deserves a little time to talk one-on-one, you know?
You know, I want to thank you for being a good friend of Mike.
Yeah, well, it's nothing compared to what Robin's done for him. I think she's the reason he's still here. How are you?
You know, I've been trying to keep it together, but I know that somewhere in there is blind rage. I just want to scream my guts out.
Yeah. I think we all feel that way.
You know, I'm amazed at where Mike is. I mean, he's so focused on what's important. More than I ever seen him.
God, Jagger. You should have seen him before all this hit him. He was doing so good. You would have been so proud of him. But did he tell you about the dyslexia?
No.
Dyslexia is the reason why he wasn't reading for all those years. I mean, once he was diagnosed, once Robin had him diagnosed, he just started reading like crazy. I mean, he was reading every book in sight. Robin's just done a lot to change his life, you know, without even trying or wanting to.
I see it. So what's going on with you? I know something is up, I can tell.
I feel really humiliated.
What happened in it? It's over with Sunny?
Yeah. You don't have to say you're sorry, because I know you're not.
I'm sorry you got hurt. You deserve only good things, Brenda.
Yeah, I'm working on that. Listen, I want you to know that Sunny is very capable of love when it comes to Stone.
Yeah, Mike told me a little bit about it.
I mean, he's really gentle and nurturing with Stone. You'd be surprised if you saw them together. It's hard not to be touched by it.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Well, this is the part I hate the most. We gotta say goodbye.
You guys are leaving already?
You're kidding. I had to jump through flaming hoops to get this much time off.
It was really good to see you guys.
You can say that again.
Where are you?
Oh. Well, I'll see you soon.
Okay. Hey, I don't want to worry because we're going to take care of him until next time.
Okay, thank you. Please do. He's very precious to us. Okay, let's go.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye.
Okay.
Take care.
Okay.
Oh. You take care.
Yeah.
Bye.
I love you, Mike, okay?
I love you too, man.
Take care of yourself, all right? Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Fine. No stuff to see them leave. I'm glad they came. It was worth it.
What is that?
I don't know. It's just, you know, I just feel like my feet are centered to the ground. You know, you and Mike are what's important in my life. And both of you are right here in the same place. I just can't bear to get on that plane and leave one of you behind.
You're gonna see him, okay? What's important is that he knows that you love him. He knows that.
I love you.
Love you.